Good morning, students. So far we have seen that the swallow at the behest of the prince, at the request of the prince, stayed back in the city with the prince for 2 nights, and he helped the seamstress and the man who was a writer and he was working in his gutter. Now this night he decided that he will fly to Egypt. So he came back to the happy prince to bid him goodbye. But then the prince said, Little swallow, will you please stay with me for 1 night longer? So the swallow answered that it is winter and very soon the snow will start falling here in the city. Egypt is sunny now. It is very warm in Egypt and all my friends have already reached there. So I should go and join my friends and enjoy the sunny climate in Egypt. But then the prince went on narrating, telling him what he was able to see. What did he see? What did the prince see? In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. He could see that there was a little match girl who was standing in the square below. Okay? And she has let her matches fall in the gutter. She was there out, you know, to sell her matches. And by any chance, all the matches fall down in the gutter and they were all spoiled. Now her father is going to beat her if she does not, you know, come back home with some money. And so she is crying. She neither has any shoes or stockings and her little head is bare. Okay? So it was, you know, getting, you know, colder in the city. And the prince felt very bad to see this little girl who had no shoes, no stockings, no cap for her head. And moreover, she has lost all the matches. And now she will not be able to sell any matches and her father is going to beat her if she goes back home without any money. So he makes a request to the swallow that, swallow, please, can you stay back with me for 1 night longer and help the little girl? Pluck out my other eye and give it to her and her father will not beat her. So what did he say? That, will you please pluck out my other eye and give it to the girl so that her father doesn't beat her? So swallow was surprised. Swallow was taken aback this time. Okay? He was surprised and astonished. And what did he say? I will surely stay with you for 1 night longer. But please don't ask me to pluck out your eyes. I cannot do that. You would be quite blind after that. If I take out your eye, then you will be blind. Swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Please do as I command you. Now, the prince was commanding the swallow to do as he was telling him to do. So what did the swallow do? He plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down with it. He swooped past the match girl and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. So what did the swallow do? He plucked the prince's other eye, because already one eye was already given to the man who was working in the garret, isn't it, the writer. So he was left with only one more eye, and that eye also he plucked out and he flew to give it to the match girl. What a lovely bit of glass, cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. Okay, the girl was delighted to see that, bit of glass. For her, it was a bit of glass, but it was a sapphire, a very costly, expensive stone. But for that little girl, okay, who was still untouched by the materialism of this world, for her, it was just a beautiful piece of glass. So she ran home laughing, okay, not really knowing the worth of that precious stone. Then the swallow came back to the prince. You are blind now, he said. So I will stay with you always. Now when the swallow came back, and he came back to find that the prince was now blind. So what did he decide? What did he say? That I am going to stay with you forever. No, little swallow, said the poor prince. You must go away to Egypt. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow, and he slept at the prince's feet. So here you can see such beautiful depiction of friendship, isn't it? Students, you can see here that the little swallow decided that he will stay back with the poor prince now, because he has lost his eyes. He cannot see anything. So he has decided that he will be his companion for the rest of his life. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow, and he slept at the prince's feet. All the next day, he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange lands. Okay, so next day, what did the bird do? He sat on the, he perched on the prince's shoulder and he was telling him what all he saw in different strange lands that he visited. He also told him what he saw in that particular city. Dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. Okay, so please underline this, students. So what is the prince saying? That dear swallow, you are narrating me stories of strange lands. Okay, beautiful stories of strange lands. You are telling me marvelous things about strange lands. But I think the most marvelous thing in this world is the suffering of men and women. The most marvelous here does not mean, he's not saying that, the suffering of men and women are beautiful. He's saying that it is very sublime, you can say, okay? Very poignant, you can say. You know, the suffering of men and women are poignant, okay? Very deep. Here, marvelous means actually deep, okay? Very touching. There is no mystery so great as misery. I don't think there is any other mystery which is as great as misery, because the universe, the world will never be able to decipher the reason why some people are poor and why some people are rich, why some people are born in poor family and why some are born in rich family. Okay, so he is saying that the greatest mystery in this world is what? Of that of misery. Why there is so much of misery in this world? That is the greatest mystery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there. Okay, now he is making a request that, dear swallow, my friend, please fly over my city and tell me what is going on in my city, because I cannot see anymore. I have lost my eyes. So you be my eyes. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses. See, here students, once again, this paragraph, okay, this particular paragraph will talk about the inequalities of our society. Okay, so the swallow flew over this great city and he saw that there was striking contrast in the lives of the people. There was one section of people who were rich and they were happy, they were merrymaking, while there were beggars who were sitting, at the gates of these rich people, okay, only for some food maybe. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich man making merry in their beautiful houses. Making merry means they were enjoying in their beautiful houses while the beggars were sitting at the gates. He flew into dark lanes, okay, and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. Okay, not only that, okay, he didn't only visit beautiful places. This time he decided that he will flew into places where not many people would visit. Okay, he visited the dark lanes, okay, where he saw the white faces of starving people. The why white faces? Because they were bloodless, so they appeared white. Okay, starving, they're hungry children, they looking out listlessly at the black street. Blankly. Listlessly means what? Blankly. Okay, without gazing at the black street, you can say. Under the archway of a bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. So under a bridge, you can see archway, isn't it? Archway wo jo ek hota hai na, matlab round shape ka jo for entrance, theek hai, वैसे ब्रिज के जो नीचे जो आर्चवे है उसके नीचे व्हाट डिड ही सी? ही सॉ टू लिटिल बॉयज वेर लाइंग इन ईच अदर्स आर्म्स. ओके, व्हाई? टू ट्राई एंड कीप देमसेल्व्स वार्म. इट वाज सो कोल्ड एंड दे हैड नो ब्लैंकेट, नो क्लोथ्स, प्रॉपर क्लोथ्स फॉर विंटर, एंड सो दे वेर होल्डिंग ईच अदर इन देयर आर्म्स टू कीप देमसेल्व्स वार्म. सो हियर वंस अगेन यू सी दिस ऑल्सो टेल्स अस अबाउट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फ्रेंड्स. सी, दिस पीपल आर पुअर, बट दिस पीपल आर एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू, इवन दो दे आर पुअर, बट दे आर ट्राइंग टू हेल्प ईच अदर, isn't it? They are, these two boys are lying in each other's arms. What does it mean? That even though they are poor, but they wanted to keep themselves warm by hugging each other. How hungry we are. So what are the boys saying? That we are very hungry. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. But then also, you see, they didn't have a house, and they were, they were trying to sit under the bridge because it was drizzling outside. But even the watchman, the watchman could not tolerate that, and he came and ordered them that they should not lie over there, they should not stay there, and they should move out of that place. So these two boys had to wander out into the rain, they moved here and there into the rain. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. I am covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. So what is he saying? The prince is saying that my body is gilded with fine gold. Okay, I'm covered with gold. So you must take it off. Okay, take out my, gold leaf, leaf by leaf. Matlab, layer after layer, you take out all the gold from my body and give it to the poor. And also he tells a very, wise thing here. What does he say? The living always think that human beings always think that gold can make them happy. But it is not. See, I am full of gold, isn't it? But I am not happy because I can see the people suffering. So leaf after leaf of the fine gold the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and grey. Now what happened? Now when layers after layer, the leaf after leaf, the fine golds were picked off from the happy prince's body. Now the happy prince looked very dull and grey, and those gold were distributed amongst the poor. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's faces grew rosier, and they laughed and played in the street. "We have bread now," they cried. And what did he do? He distributed it amongst the poor children, and the children were now happy. Okay, they laughed and played in the street, saying that they had bread now. Then the snow came. Now what happened? It's extremely cold now in that city. Okay, now the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. Okay, the snow was accompanied by the frost. The streets, you can see students, one thing, snow and frost is a recurring symbol in Oscar Wilde's story, because in your last class you have in class 8 when you studied the shellfish giant, the image of snow and frost was used by Oscar Wilde in that story also, isn't it? So you can see that Oscar Wilde uses the image of snow and frost, okay, recurrently, okay, several times in his stories in various places. So once again, then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. The street looked as if they were made of silver, because it was covered with snow, white. Everybody went about in furs. They were all covering themselves with furs. Furs, you know, very, you know, woolen, heavy woolen clothes. And the little boys wear scarlet caps and wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. And, you know, the little boys, they were wearing scarlet caps and they were skating on the ice. The poor little swallow grew colder and colder. But what about the poor little girl? It was growing colder and colder. But he would not leave the prince. But he still didn't want to go to Egypt now. He loved him too well, because he loved the prince so much. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking, and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. So whenever the bakers dropped, some extra crumbs of bread outside his room, what did he do? He used to pick those crumbs of bread and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. So he was trying to subdue his hunger some way. He was trying to manage his hunger some way. But at last he knew that he was going to die. But at last, you know, how long he will survive in that way, isn't it? Excuse me, students.